Hello, literature lovers. Today we are going to talk about George Crabbe. He was an English poet, surgeon, and clergyman. He is best known for his early use of realistic narrative form and his descriptions of middle and working class life and people. In the 1770s, Crabbe began his career as a doctor's apprentice, later becoming a surgeon. In 1780, he traveled to London to make a living as a poet. After encountering serious financial difficulty and being unable to have his work published, he wrote to the statesman and author Edmund Burke for assistance. Burke was impressed enough by Crabbe's poems to promise to help him in any way he could. The two became close friends, and Burke helped Crabbe greatly both in his literary career and in building a role within the church. Burke introduced Crabbe to the literary and artistic society of London, including Sir Joshua Reynolds and Samuel Johnson, who read The Village before its publication and make some minor changes. Burke secured Crabbe the important position of Chaplain to the Duke of Rutland. Crabbe served as a clergyman in various capacities for the rest of his life. With Burke's continued help in securing these positions, he developed friendships with many of the great literary men of his day, including Sir Walter Scott, whom he visited in Edinburgh, and William Wordsworth and some of his fellow lake poets who frequently visited Crabbe as his guests. Lord Byron described him as a nature's sternest painter, yet the best. Crabbe's poetry was predominantly in the form of heroic couplets and has been described as unsentimental in its depiction of provincial life and society. The modern critic Frank Whitehead wrote that Crabbe in his verse tales is an important indeed, a major poet whose work has been and still is seriously undervalued. Crabbe's works include The Village, 1783, Poems, 1807, The Brogue, 1810, and his poetry collections, Tales, 1812, and Tales of the Hall, 1819. Wordsworth predicted that Crabbe's poetry would last from its combined merits as truth and poetry fully as long as anything that has been expressed in words since it first made its appearance. Though on another occasion, according to Henry Crabb Robinson, he blamed Crabb for his unpoetical mode of considering human nature and society. This last opinion was also held by William Hazlitt, who complained that Crabb's characters remind one of anatomical preservations or may be said to be a some traits. That's all for today. I hope you must have got an overall perspective. Thanks for being part of it. Thank you.